Hey guys, how you doing tonight? As you know, Mac has released OS 10 Maverick, and with that upgrade, there are a lot of upgrades to apps coming down the pipe. And one of them that came down, which made me want to stick a pencil in my eye, was iMovie. Now, I'm usually really flexible about upgrades, and I like to try new things, but this one made me want to shoot myself. So let me kind of walk you through this a little bit so you don't feel like drinking a bottle of Sterno or anything. Okay, so click on iMovie. This is just going to be a quick basic tutorial. Don't look for anything flashy in this. Okay, so you open this up and you're like, okay, here's my timeline. I got my clips in here. All right, I don't know why they're not together. Let's say I want to split this one. Oh, where's the split? It's not here. Well, guys, this is not the timeline, at least not at this point. This is just your clips that are in this event here. Now, why they changed this down to here from up here, I have no idea. Anyway, this is what we're going to do. If we're going to make a movie, we're going to go to Create. Or you can go to File, New Movie. Create works. Okay, Create, Movie. And we'll just go with you got all these themes in here, you know how it is. We'll go with no theme. My movie's okay, fine. Okay, now we have a timeline. Okay, well let's make a whole new thing. So File, New Event, as usual. We'll just leave that. Import Media. Now this I actually like. This is kind of a cool upgrade. Click on that, and it pulls this up. So you got your FaceTime, you got your phone, boot camp, Macintosh hard drive, desktop, and whatever the hell that is. Okay, so anyway, we'll just grab something off my phone. Oh, okay, here we go. We'll take this one. Import selected. Okay, so now we've got this up here. And it used to show you the little progress bar here, but I think it's this little clock here. I think that'll show you the progress. Now, if you want to make this bigger, you can come here and you can make it bigger like that. Now you can zoom in on the clip like that. You can show the audio with it. Probably take a second for that to load up. I like to keep them about that size. And I really don't care about showing the... Anyway, so you can see that it's... there we go. You can see that's showing the progress here. I believe they're allowing us to edit on the fly. So, what you can do... Sorry, I'm going to turn those waveforms off. What you can do to select this clip, you can right-click it and select entire clip. Or you can just double-click it and select the whole thing. Then you just grab it, pull her down the timeline just as we did before. Everything's pretty much the same. If you want to make this bigger, same. You can go over here to this little clip. Bigger, small as you want. I like it about there. I don't really need to show the audio on this one. It's not going to be an integral part of this video. Okay, so we'll do it about like that. So, if you want to split the clip, same thing. You can right-click. You've got the split. Or it's up here in File. Or, I'm sorry, in Modify. Split clip, sorry. Modify. Sorry. Click on it where you want to split it. Modify, split clip. Okay, and it puts a split in there. One other thing I want to show you guys was your content library is over here now, where it used to slide in from the side over here. Now it is here. If you click on transitions, they're going to come up here. You got all your various choices of transitions that you can play with here. Your titles, same. A lot of new titles in here, but nothing really to write home about. Maps and backgrounds, doesn't look like they upgraded anything to me. Come on, Apple, we're getting tired of this curtain and this underwater scene and this industrial thing. You can get music from your iTunes. And look, I've got AC/DC in there. That means I'm cool. Let's see, what else we got in there? Aerosmith, all right, Godsmack. Okay, sound effects. This is nice. They've got a whole lot of stuff in here. Look at that. This is way more than what they had before. So for this, just play around in here and see what you got. Didn't sound like a gun to me. What about a hammer? Really? So anyway, you can get stuff from GarageBand. The next thing, the titles. I wanted to show you that. This one had me almost splitting my head open with a hammer. Okay, import complete. Fine. From this first one down to Prism Lower Third, all of these titles, you cannot change the fonts. Cannot change the fonts or the font size. These are the way they are. So if you want to use this one, you pull it down in here like that, double click on it to, you know, put in your Mully Eats Kiss Burger. And if you know the video, you know what I'm talking about. So anyway, if you want to change the text, you go here, highlight it, but it won't let you choose the text. If you've got your editing bar up here. Nope, won't do it. So those first, 4, 8, 12, 16, you can't, 4, 8, 12, yeah, first 16, you can't change the text. The ones that you can change this text start from here at the centered. So you can take this, pull it down in here as you did, double click it. Here you can change your text, your font size, your alignment, bold, all that other stuff. Color. Okay. Oh, okay. They got the crayons like they used to. So that's how that works. And then when you go to render your video, you're going to go up here to share, and you're going to get theater, email, iTunes, YouTube, Facebook, Vimeo, CNN iReport, and file. I know a lot of people upload directly to YouTube. I've never really liked doing that. I prefer to render out a file to my desktop and save it and upload it myself. So if you want to render it to your desktop, just hit file. It's going to have your movie here. Next, my movie, and save. And then it's going to be saving right here. It's going to take a while. Again, I don't see a progress bar here anywhere. Maybe it's here. Maybe it's a circle up here. Yeah, show activity. You just got to wait for it. If you go here and click the theater button, you can see that it's sitting here too, and this is going to...
Hey guys, how you doing? Well...
And what I tell you guys, a Kiss Burger was this.
We definitely saved this paper, right?
Right.
This was
nice.
Something they had here in Japan about a week ago. It's pretty good.
It's spicy hot.
Wow. It's really spicy hot.
Okay, so anyway, your movie will save here on your desktop, and it will save a copy in your theater. You don't have to keep that. You can delete it. This will still render out, and when it's ready, it'll let you know. I'm going to go ahead and shut this down. If you want to close iMovie, task currently will not be completed. That's fine. I don't need to save this movie. Okay, so finish that. Now, the one last thing I want to show you guys before we go, if this new iMovie just makes you want to drink a can full of Sterno, I've got something for you. Go over to your applications file, and over here you've got the iMovie icon in here. Well, right next to it, iMovie 9.0.9, click that. Look at this. There is your old iMovie. So you can go home again. All right, guys. What do we got here? Okay. So anyway, guys, that is it. Wish you guys luck with this. If I figure out any other stuff, I'll make another tutorial. But for now, we'll leave that as it is. I hope this helped. And if you have any questions, leave them down in the comments. And if I have an answer, I'll let you know. All right, guys, take it easy and don't let your meatloaf.